It was a simple tackling drill during summer practice of the Nashua North football team. Sophomore Cooper Doucette was about to bring down a runner, but he says he was at a funny angle and his helmet hit the ball carrier's knees.
So I just lost my breath and just went down and tried to get up and just couldn't. And I thought I was paralyzed, but I wasn't for sure. And when I was down, couldn't move anything, I knew.
Cooper broke a vertebrae in his neck, an injury that left him paralyzed from the mid-chest down. There were months of rehabilitation in Atlanta, and along with the emotional and physical issues, there were some practical concerns, too. The Doucette's home needed to be renovated to fit with Cooper's needs. In just 3 weeks, a team of contractors and volunteers did just that.
It's meant the world to us. Overwhelming support. We've said to Cooper many times how we can't believe that one person has brought an entire community together.
The Doucettes now have a new entryway, bathroom, and their dining room is now Cooper's bedroom. The front ramp was built by Nashua firefighters with donated labor and materials.
We were able to do it. You know, we have a lot of talented guys on the job, and we were able to pull them all together.
The family held a luncheon Friday to thank everyone involved with the project. Cooper's parents know there is still a long way to go, but Cooper is focused on Saturday when his teammates play Pinkerton for the Division I state championship.
It's been real good seeing everyone, just because I missed everyone, not seeing anyone, being so far away, and just perfect timing for the big game. I'm going to win.
Victories are measured in different ways, and with his family's love and community support, Cooper looks like a champion. In Nashua, Andy Hirschberger, WMUR News 9.